Hello everyone, this is Eva from Jumico Studios. Google has released its new version of Google Analytics, Google Analytics for Property. You might have received an email or a notification from Google. So, what is Google Analytics for Property? What are some of the main features? And what action should you take for your business? In this video, I will answer all those questions so that you can be ready for the next generation of Google Analytics. The current universal Google Analytics is really built around the idea of page view and session, and it is more for desktop user. It has always been a challenge to see data across different platform, device, and it's really hard to connect the dot if you have a mobile app for your business. Well, the new Google Analytics for Property is built based on the Google Analytics app plus web. As the name suggested, it has the ability to track traffic from both your mobile app and website. Instead of focusing on page view session, the new GA4 property is built more around the idea of events. It's enhanced measurement, automatically track events like clicks, website search, and file download, without you having to install additional code to your website or set up event tracking with Google Tag Manager. Another advantage is the deeper integration with other Google products. You can now create and maintain audience and see conversion like YouTube engage view across your mobile and website. When you log into your new GA4 property, on the left side of the dashboard, you will notice that some of the reports are built around your customer lifecycle, from acquisition, engagement, monetization, to retention. All those changes are designed to provide you more flexibility in terms of how to create, interpret data, and have an overall understanding of how users engage with your business. The second key feature of GA4 property is it uses machine learning to provide insight and trend. We have seen Google using machine learning on a different product, Google AdWords. With Google AdWords, you have functionality like automated bidding, smart campaign, and suggest the ad copy. With GA4 property, it's using machine learning to provide you automated insight on your traffic, and it highlights those changes directly on the homepage of your dashboard. It also tries to use machine learning to predict your customer behavior. Two of the metrics they're providing right now are predicted churn and predicted conversion. I'm pretty sure Google will continue to add more predicted metrics over time. The last key feature I want to talk about is data privacy. We all know data privacy is and will continue to be a big topic and investment for business. The new GA4 property provides business more control in terms of how the data is collected and managed. You will see a consent API where you implement GA4 property using global site tag. It essentially allows you to adjust the Google tag based on the consent status of your user. You can also disable ad personalization based on country, and you can delete the exact data you want or need to delete using the data deletion control. Here is an overview of what Google Analytics for Property is and some of the key features. So what action should you take for your business? I recommend you to set up Google Analytics for Property in parallel with your current universal Google Analytics. This way, you can start to track data with the new GA4 property, get yourself familiar with the dashboard, and still have access to your current universal Google Analytics report. Now I will show you how you can set up a Google Analytics for Property using Google Tag Manager. Okay, first, log in to your Google Analytics account. Under Admin, you will see an option to upgrade to GA4. If you don't see this option and you don't want to wait, you can simply click on Create Property and create a new Google Analytics 4 property by following the steps. Since I already have the option to upgrade, I'm going to go this way. From here, you can create a new GA4 property or connecting to an existing if you have already created one. Since I do not have it yet for my website, I'm going to click on Get Started. If you installed Universal Google Analytics by using JTag.js tracking code, you can just enable data collection without having to make any changes to your website. I cannot choose this option because I installed the Google Analytics code by using Google Tag Manager. So I will just click on Create Property. Now the Google Analytics 4 property is created under the same Google Analytics account. Under Admin, Data String, you can see my website is added as a data string. If you have app for your business, you can also add them here. Click on my website data string. You can see all the information. Under the Google Analytics 4 property, enhanced measurement is enabled automatically. As you can see here, Google Analytics 4 property will automatically track page view, scroll, outbound clicks, site search, video engagement, and file download event. With the universal Google Analytics property, you actually had to set this up all individually. We have the G4 property set up in Google Analytics. Now we have to actually configure the code on the website so that we can start to collect the data. If you are not using Google Analytics at the moment, you can add the global set tag to your website to start tracking the data by using GA4 property. You can also add this code by using Google Tag Manager, which I highly recommend. I personally like to use Google Tag Manager to install and manage all the third-party code. All the codes are on one place, which makes it a lot easier to manage all third-party code. Now let's head over to my Google Tag Manager account. Here you can see that I'm already tracking my website traffic using the universal Google Analytics tag. I will create a new one for Google Analytics 4 property. Click New, and I will name this tag GA4 Property. Under Tag Configuration, choose Google Analytics GA4 Configuration. I can copy the measurement ID from Google Analytics and copy the measurement ID here. Make sure that you are triggering this tag on all pages. Then save. Then hit submit. GA4 property. And publish this change. Now I have both universal Google Analytics tag and Google Analytics 4 property tag on my website, which means that I'm collecting my website data for both property. To make sure that I have GA4 property tag installed correctly, I will go to my website, then head over to Google Analytics real-time report. As you can see, GA4 property is already collecting data. That's it. I hope you have a better understanding of what the new Google Analytics 4 property is. Are you going to implement it for your business? Let me know in the comment below. Hope to see you next time. Bye.